Thank you. Thank you. It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I can never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me wherever I fall. Say it best when you say nothing at all. All day long I can hear people talking out loud. But when you as they may, they can never define what's been said between your heart and mine. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me wherever.
You say it best when you say nothing at all. In times of darkness, love sees. In times of silence, love hears. In times of doubt, love hopes. And in times of sorrow, love heals. And in all times, love remembers. May time soften the pain until all that remains is the warmth of the memories and the love. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come together today in remembrance of a special person in our lives, Rebecca Louise Barrett. On behalf of her children, Bree, Zach deceased, Chet, Charlie, Bryce and Gina, I welcome you all and thank you for being with them today. I also welcome all those joining us online as they were unable to be here. The kindness of friends and family who have stood by the family during this difficult time is much appreciated and will be consolation to them later during the inevitable moments of grief and emptiness. The family warmly invites you all to join them here after the service to share your stories of Rebecca and to support one another. In your sadness, it is important to remember grief is a passage, not a place to stay. Grief is not a sign of weakness nor a lack of faith. It is the price of love. There are people who leave an indelible mark on your soul, an input that can never be erased. Grief is not a disorder or a disease. It is an emotional, physical, and spiritual necessity, the price you pay for love. The only cure for grief is to grieve. It will be the little things that you remember, the quiet moments, the smiles, the laughter. And although it might seem hard right now, it will be the memories of those little things that help to push away the pain and bring the smiles back again. This funeral service has many purposes. Of course, it is for the reverent farewell of Rebecca, but it also recognises and acknowledges the value of her life, and it confirms that life has ended. This service will help those remaining to face the reality of her death. No matter whatever the relationship you had with Rebecca, her death has broken in upon it. This service will give us the opportunity to reflect upon the hole that is left with the passing of a dearly loved mother, grandma, daughter, sister, aunt, and dear friend to so many. A chance to remember how a spark of divine energy from a determined and strong person made our world a better place. The hurt is almost unbearable, yet we will live through it. It is because we feel such deep pain, it is because the inner ache is so great that we realise how much we loved her. And yet the agony inside gives us strange comfort. It tells us how much we will miss her, and we really wouldn't want to feel any other way, because the grief and the heartache we feel bears witness to the depth of our love. We know that thoughts of her will forever bring us comfort. Born on the 19th of April 1974. After leaving school, she worked at the Shorewell IGA and later joined Leslie, her mother-in-law, Bree, in 1995, and also Zach, sadly a stillbirth, followed by Chet in 1997, Charlie in 1999, Bryce in 2001, and Gina in 2004. Tim and Rebecca separated in 2008 but remained friends right up until the end. Rebecca was a devoted mum. Her children were the centre of her universe, always putting their needs first and doing anything and everything she could to support them and be there for them. She was ecstatic when the grandchildren, Arlo and Eloise, came along, and she delighted in every moment she could share with them. She was always busy with the family. Rebecca's best friend was Julie. They would often laugh together, calling themselves the rebels without a cause. Beck loved the V8s, loved Holdens, and loved the soaps, especially The Bold and the Beautiful and Home and Away. She loved the Carlton Footy Club and her dog, Indy, a Staffy Cross Blue heeler who was by her side when she passed and who today is mourning the loss of her devoted companion. She loved taking the kids camping every Christmas holiday to Stanley, Sisters Beach or Black River. Wonderful memories were made during these holidays. Rebecca loved Christmas and would organise family get-togethers at a park. Not too much fuss, but happy days of togetherness playing cricket as a family. She loved all the places she lived, Tagari, West Ridgely, and especially Burnie, as her family were always nearby. But most of all, she simply loved her family. Her home was always the gathering hub for everyone, and there was always a huge tub of chocolates to be shared by all. Rebecca suffered several illnesses since her mid-30s, but a brain aneurysm in 2011 left her with impaired motor skills and some new challenges in her life. Tough, strong, determined, and resilient, she was stoic in accepting her lot and would always state, "I'm all right," whenever she was asked how she was. She would never complain, facing her life with courage and positivity. We love and miss you so much, Rebecca. Rest peacefully until we meet again. We now have the privilege to look at a first set of photographs that have been chosen from the albums to show us aspects of Rebecca's life. The chosen song to support this set of photos is Wild, Wild Angels by Smokey.
Dreams, cause you don't know what it means to live for someone else you can't just take. Oh, when you're bitten by the truth, you blame it on your misspent youth. You never seem to learn by your mistakes. So don't talk to me, I'm wild. Those wild, wild angels on the high. what wild, wild angels have to face. Oh, I ain't hang around to see you turn on someone else like me. I'm still alive, and you know the way I live. But baby, that's one way you'll never be. Such simple things you fail to see. You take back everything you ever give. So don't talk to me.
Memories that you have in there. We have a couple of tributes this morning, and the first is written by the children, Bree, Chet, Charlie, Bryce and Gina. They have asked if I would share this with you. And it reads, "Good morning and thank you all for joining us in celebrating the life of our mother, Rebecca. And thank you to all of you who have reached out and helped us through this difficult time. Mum would be so grateful to each and every one of you for looking out for her children. We were her entire world. Dear Mum, thank you for always putting us first, even if it meant sacrificing things for yourself. We are so grateful for everything you did for us and how much you loved us. We are the people we are today because of you. You were always there when we needed you, whether it was a shoulder to cry on, parenting advice, asking dumb questions, or just to talk. You were so proud of us and all our achievements. Even the little ones. We were truly blessed to have you as a mother. We will cherish all our memories spent together just being a family. Although Arlo and Eloise might be too young to remember the moments spent with you, they will know just how much you loved them and how proud you were to show them off every chance you got. You were always happy to have them, even if you weren't feeling the best. They both loved FaceTiming and talking to you on the phone. They knew you had the good snacks and where to find them. They loved you just as much as you loved them. They will always have their grandma watching over them. When we were teenagers, we remember our house being full of laughter. All our friends loved being in our house because to them you were a second mother. And to our partners as well, you always treated our partners as part of the family. Your bravery, strength, and resilience were truly inspiring. With all that life threw at you, you never gave up and kept fighting the good fight. And through it all, you still managed to keep a smile on your face. We are so proud of you. Although our hearts are broken that you are no longer with us, we take comfort in the fact that you are no longer in pain. Rest peacefully. We miss you and we love you so very, very much. Beautiful words. Rebecca's sister Michelle is going to come forward and present a tribute.
Thank you. Firstly, I would like to thank Bree and Chet for giving me the privilege of writing a tribute for their mother, my sister. Well, little sis, how do I say goodbye when I didn't get a chance to? You were taken so suddenly, and as to why, I will never stop asking. It still feels like a dream that I haven't woken up from yet. You were an amazing tower of strength with all the health issues you had to deal with over the years. After suffering a personal tragedy losing your beautiful son, Zach, you still managed to keep your family together. You were so proud of all your children and loved your grandchildren so very much. One of my fondest memories of Rebecca and I growing up was when we used to ride our bikes at Nan Elson's. We used to pretend we were in a car race. I have to admit, I won most of the time and was the one doing the lap of honour with the checkered flag, but you were right behind me. We were really close as children, and as normal sisters do, we had our fair share of arguments over the times. One thing that sticks in my mind most was when I was 16, and after getting my first job, I bought a massive stereo and told Beck not to touch it. Well, while I was at work, she had that stereo pumping. Patsy may or may not have dobbed you in. My sister would be so proud of all her children and the way they have all stepped up helping each other out through this extremely hard time. They have truly worked as a team and are all very strong people. Each one of you should be extremely proud of yourself in the way you have adapted in such a tragedy of circumstances, because we as a family certainly are all proud of you. I have another piece of my heart gone. Rest in peace, my beautiful sister, until we meet again.
Thank you, Michelle. One of the hardest challenges you probably ever have to face. A second set of photographs have been selected by the family. Dean Lewis singing "How Do I Say Goodbye" has been chosen to accompany them.
Early morning, there's a message on my phone. It's my mother saying, "Darling, please come home." I fear the worst, but how could you leave us all behind? There's so much to say, but there's so little time. So how do I say goodbye? Someone who's been with me for my whole damn life. You gave me my name and the color of your eyes. See your face when I look couldn't. You always saw the best in me. Right or wrong, you were always on my side. But I'm scared of what life without you's like. And I saw the way she looked into your eyes. And I promise if you go, I will make sure she's alright. So how do I say goodbye? Someone who's been with me for my whole damn life. You gave me my name and the color of your eyes. I see your face when I look at mine. So gonna steal some time and start again. You'll always be my closest friend. And someday we're gonna make it out. Just hold the light, just hold the light high, high. So how do I say goodbye to someone who's been with me for my whole damn life? You gave
family was truly the center of her universe, as we've just seen. You can shed tears that she's gone, or you can smile because she lived. You can close your eyes and pray that she'll come back, or you can open your eyes and see all that she has left. Your heart can be empty because you cannot see her, or you can be full of the love that you shared. You can turn your back on tomorrow and love yesterday, or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday. You can remember her and only that she's gone, or you can cherish her memory and let it live on. You can cry and close your mind, be empty and turn your back. Or you could do what she would want. Smile, open your eyes, love, and go on. A special time in our service, a time now to place your flowers and say your quiet goodbyes.
See my baby when I leave.
As we celebrate Rebecca's life, we can take satisfaction that she has been and still is and always will be a part of our life. Her influence endures in the unending consequences flowing from her character and her deeds. When I go, don't learn to live without me. Just learn to live with my love in a different way. And if you need to see me, close your eyes or look in your shadow when the sun shines. Sit with me in the quiet and you will know that I did not leave. There is no leaving when a soul is blended with another. When I go, don't learn to live without me. Just learn to look for me in the moment. I will be there. It is now time to lay a much-loved mother, grandma, daughter, sister, aunt, and treasured friend to rest. Would you all please stand? Tenderly and reverently, we commit the body of Rebecca Louise Barrett to the elements and ultimately to Mother Earth, from which all life comes and to which in the end all life returns. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, grateful for the life that has been lived and for all that life meant to us. May we remember the depths of her love, the depths of her kindness, and that special way that she did indeed touch our lives. I have no doubt that all of you here are grateful for Rebecca's life, for the life that has been lived, and for what it has meant to you personally. We are glad that she lived. We are glad that she was part of our life. We cherish the memories that we have of her, and we know she will never be forgotten. May tender memories soften your grief. May fond recollections bring you relief, and may you find comfort and peace when thinking of Rebecca. So go forward today with a small flickering of light in your soul. May the memories of Rebecca begin to bring comfort rather than pain. May the words, touch, and presence of others bring solace. Thus thinking of her, let us leave this place in quietness of spirit and live with love and concern for others as she would want us to do. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Guess you could say we've been through a lot. We stuck with each other, like it or not. But there's nothing like friends to make you feel alive. We didn't win every battle, but God knows we tried. Here's to the sinners, here's to the saints, here's to the people I'd like to thank. You drink to me, I drink to you, let's drink together. But before we do, if we die tonight, it'll be alright, 'cause we had one hell of a ride. Up some dust and we sure made some noise. But girls will be girls and us boys will be boys. They called us crazy, we
prove them wrong. They'll be talking about us long after we're gone. Oh, here's to the sinners, here's to the saints, here's to the people I'd like to thank. You drink to me, I drink to you, let's drink together, but before we do.